That is, you will be getting, you all know that your term one, this is a multiple choice question paper, okay? 60 questions. And out of those 60, you have to do 50, right? It will be divided into different sections. You have your reading and your writing and your grammar and literature, okay? And the choices would be within the section. So if in your reading section, you have two passages and 12 questions are there, you have to do 10 questions. That means you're supposed to do 10. It's not that because I know all the answers, I'll do 12 from here and from the others, I might do two less. No. Section wise, the appropriate question numbers have to be there, right? So over attempt is not going to get you more marks in one question. So in one section, if it is 10 questions, the next two will not be checked. Clear? So do not over attempt. And this applies everywhere. In any exam that you have, do not. And when or is given, supposing two extracts are there. One extract is given, questions are given after that. Then another or is there. Okay? Then the next extract is given. The corresponding, you know, like question numbers you will fill. So naturally here, you've done 10 questions, you've left 11 and 12. So next circle, where would it be? On the 13th one, or like what? Yeah, you've left two, so it will be 13, isn't it? Not 11. And remember that it is not necessary that all your answers will be circled in a sequence because you have left also. And learn to make wise and smart choices, right? Answers that you are confident about, answers that you are very, very sure about, because in multiple choices, the answers are very close, right? And this pattern, it is according to CBSE paper, fine? And so that when you have your term one exam, you will not have any problem. So according to the day sheet, which has been circulated, I think so our English is almost in the end, in the term one, right? Okay. But here we're having it in the beginning. And there is no shortcut for your multiple choice questions. You have to read the chapters. Your content is good enough, automatically you get the answers, right? So for writing skills, yes, here, what could the question be like? It could be based on the format, okay? It could be your fill in the blanks. Like I've given the format of the letter here, I've given the content also here. So maybe some answers are missing. Lines are missing, right? So there's a line missing over here in the address part, in the content part. There's a line missing over here, right? Line missing at the end and the numbers are given, say 16, 17, 18. Where are you going to write your answer? The corresponding question. Okay, so this is your question 16. This is your question 18, right? So this would be given initially. There'll be numbers over here also. And then you'll find it. Where are the questions? The questions are going to be after this, right? Read the questions, look at the blank here and fill the appropriate or tick mark the appropriate question. So this is one question which can be a little tricky to understand. Okay. Rest questions are, I think, so quite simple and clear because extract based questions you'll be able to do. Yes. Grammar is gap filling. Right. And yes, do read which is the gap that you have to complete. Sometimes we miss out, you know, the infinitives or things like that. Simple like that. Two is already there and still need to take the option which has two in it. These are little things that you have to keep in mind. Even in comprehension also, don't think that just because the question is from this line, this is where the answer is. Read the line after it also, and you will be given enough reading time. And that reading time, obviously, where are you going to use it? For your comprehension. Right? And getting two passages, maybe more than 200 words that you have to read. So read carefully. Vocabulary questions, One is that, you know, how do we find out the meanings of vocabulary? Look at the word which is given. You can look at the paragraph. If you replace it with that word, is it still meaningful? This is the basic, simplest thing to do, right? Place that word in context which you think is there. If you're not sure of its meaning, look at the words which are before and after. Does it convey a sense? Right? So this way you can find out your vocabulary questions, because it is very difficult to know the meanings of each and every word which is there. Our vocabulary is very limited because we don't like to read. We don't like to learn new words, right? Because we think we know everything. And English, who bothers to study? We don't. We have other things to do. So when it comes to vocabulary, this is why you lose marks. So please, you can do it in context. You can find out the meaning there. And yes, here, right? So of course, some words you might be able to comprehend also. Okay. So coming to the next part, writing section, it can come as content-based questions, as format-based questions, as in the form of blanks. You should know your format. I've discussed it a number of times, right? What is the heading? Where is the subject? Where is the complementary clause? Are there enclosures? Is there a postscript? Whatever, whatever, we have done that. Okay. Grammar, simple, gap filling, right? Okay. Then comes your literature. What kind of questions here? Extract based. From extracts, you can get directly questions here, if you're lucky enough. But yes, because there are a variety of questions which we have done in the previous exams also, right? So extract based questions, right? So finding out the meaning could be there. What is it that the writer wants to say? Your inference based, your value based, okay? Beyond the text. Right, so it could be like when Nelson Mandela talks about complete freedom. What does he refer to? Right, is it only about his freedom to go any place in the country? Or is it, yes, the freedom of living as a, what you can say, respectful, dignified citizen? So we have to understand, or we have to realize what was there in the text. Right, okay. Then you have, yes, your facts and opinion-based questions. Facts. What are facts? What are facts? Information which you've been cramming for so long. That's what we've been doing. All facts we have. What is opinion? It's your view, right? What do you understand from this fact? Okay? So it is your opinion. Now here, you know what little tricks you can use, because you want to save time also. You're very, very confident of the answer. Pick up anything. Yeah, I know this fact. What is it? We can do our permutation combinations also. Okay, I find this fact. I found three. And yes, I know opinions are one and four. Right, so where is two? In which option is there two? Is it with the fact or is it with opinion? If you don't want to waste too much of time, because this is one question where we do spend a lot of time. Facts and opinions, it does take time, right? Next, it could be your question in sequence. Which event came first, which came later, right? And yes, all the stories there, the sequence can be made. Whether it's about the thief's story, whether it is about triumph without surgery, right? So all of them, they have a sequence of events, because every story has a sequence, right? Okay, it could be a sequence about, yes, the events that happened in Nelson Mandela's life, right? Or the events of the day. How did it begin, right? What was inauguration about? Of course, yes, here, how it was. Everyone is seated, all the leaders coming and meeting him, even the, you know, like the high-ranked officials of the army meeting, and then the speech, or you can say before that, there was a spectacular display by the the planes there, right? Yes, the jet there, right? The colors and everything there. So there's a sequence with that also, isn't it? Right? So yeah, you can get match the answers. I've given you certain options and you're going to match with that and then find answer is the correct sequence, right? A, 3, B, 2, C, 4, and D, 1, that way. So you have to find your correct option and do that. Gap filling, which is the correct word, okay? Right? So you have to remember that. One thing, what is it that you're going to remember? Where are you going to mark the answer? In the correct corresponding. Mehul, you're not feeling well? Are you okay? Are you well? Is it properly? If you need medical aid, go. Right? So in the correct corresponding question, that is where you are going to darken it properly. And you know the proper technique. Darken it nicely. Don't put a cross. No overwriting. No whitener. Nothing. Okay? Fine? Yes. So come on. Let me see how much you are prepared with. I've just opened the book randomly. And the first question which comes to here is, do you remember the word? Which chapter is this mentioned? Polak. Yes, yes. Very good. Very good. So what does Polak reveal? It is discrimination on the basis of race, gender, religion, or wealth. Race. So he also calling them Polaks, right? Coming from Poland. Yes, from Polish. Okay. Right. Now, yes, what is migration? According to you, what is migration? Yes, what moving from, and is it only humans who migrate? No, we have among birds and animals. So here, you know, like there are, once again here, the word it could be, like I gave you also last time, just to find out the correct meaning. It was used in a sentence, right? So I went to the office to ask for my migration certificate. Is it appropriate here? Right? So yes, you can say scientists, they observe the migration patterns of birds, different seasons, right? So if the, you know, like just find out which meaning is conveyed correctly. This is something, once again, it is vocabulary. And you cannot blame anyone here for lack of vocabulary. Who is to be blamed? Because we don't read enough, right? We don't like to look at Hardik also. Hardik, get up, please. Please tell me your medical issue. What is your problem? Stand up. Yes? What's the problem? You can't sit straight in the class? How old are you, Hardik? How old are you? Are you sure? 16-year-old boys don't go around lying around in the classroom. They're quite energetic and active. Are you only good enough for screaming and shouting in the class? Yes, you are. Want to lie down? Go find a bed for yourself or go to the medical room. Tell your problem that I have a sleeping issue. Can't stay awake during the class. So remain standing if you can't sit properly. Why did Wanda give Peggy and Maddie one of her drawings? Last girl, please stand up. Stand up, please. Suhani? Okay. Maddie and Peggy asked her if they could have one. Don't shake your head even. Again, you're shaking. I said, don't shake your head. Still, Wanda was trying to get rid of them. It was her way of letting them know she forgave them. Wanda wanted them to have a drawing of one of the dresses she owned. Read carefully. Should I repeat? It's not last. C option. That Wanda wanted them to have a drawing of one of the dresses she owned. Actually, she drew the painting with them in mind. When the girls looked carefully at the dresses, what did they see? Their faces, right? And yes, so she specifically wrote in the letter that those should be given to them. Otherwise, she could have said they can take any painting. Why those? Because she always thought of them as a friend. Those girls might not have thought of her as a friend. They might have made fun of her, bullied her every day, but she was there, at least someone is talking to her. Right? Okay, sit down. How did Maddie know that Wanda had drawn the dress for her? This you can tell me without even telling me, without letting me know the option. Just fine, we just discussed that because Yes, her face was there. Yes, what's your name? Harshit. Okay. So then there are facts and opinions. You might get a picture kind of a question. I don't think so. We'll give, but yes, CBSE can be quite creative and you might get pictures here. So which could be the appropriate picture describing a situation, right? So any kind of a situation it could be. So maybe you're talking about a tricky. What was Tricky's problem? He was overweight, right? He was pampered and overfed, isn't it right? So maybe you can get pictures there. So which of the pictures that it identifies his condition, right? So you have to read the picture with a word, with the situation, okay? So I'm telling you here because when you go to the sample papers, you find a lot of variety and CBSE is making a lot of efforts to make your paper very interesting and scoring and challenging also. And this is a true test of your preparation, isn't it? Okay, so yes, yeah. Attention class, everyone back to their seat. Why did Miss Mason say so? She wanted to start a new lesson. She wanted to read about the letter from Wanda's father. The students were making noise. They were 10 feet. Okay, she wanted to make some important announcements. So two answers are very, very close. So first she made the, did she make any announcement? Or did she read the letter? Then after reading the letter, what did she say? She didn't think that my class would behave like this, right? That you would not have behaved like this with Wanda, isn't it? Right? So yes, this is how, like when you talk about the second part, this is where it begins from, right? So the class there, first of all, they're filing around and looking at the pictures and then she's telling them that I want to make an important, all right, well, let's read this letter from Wanda. So do you remember that girl? And yes, sir. Who had written a letter to Miss Mason? Yes, first, so look here, we have Wanda Petronsky, Wanda's mother, Han Petronsky, or was it Wanda's sister? What was Wanda's brother's name? And her father was? Han. Okay, it's not her, it's her. Okay, Han Petronsky. Okay, fine. Yes, which... And there's some questions which are talking about, you know, like expressions and all. Okay, the line, plenty of funny names in the city, suggests that the city, what? Where has this line been taken from? Plenty of father's letter, right? Very nice, very good. And yes, what do you think it means? Plenty of funny names in the city. That it's a melting pot of people from different parts of the world? Has foreign people willing to give opportunities to the poor? Is a safe haven for immigrants if they have funny names? Is it? Has a special status for all who are willing to be funny? A seems to be. What's a melting pot? Melting pot of people from different parts of the world. Melting pot. So they all come together. There's no difference, right? Yes, so that inclusion happens, right? So that diversity is accepted. So here it is, yes. And in the big city, no one has time even. No one makes fun of anyone because of their different name and they accept everyone. So there, no one would make fun of him. Children. So that is why he had decided to shift over here. The way a crow shook down on me in the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. Poem. Poet. Although these are the most least likely questions to be asked, but still just to make you a little awake. Okay, now here. Yes, so what does a crow symbol of? What is a crow symbolic of? Negativity, sorrow, a bad omen, death, isn't it right? And what is a hemlock tree? It's a poisonous tree. So both things are here negative. Okay, right. And which tree did the crow shake? Very easy. Hemlock tree. Okay, here. Now, here is a question, right? Have I done a cynic docy with you? Have I done this literary device cynic docy with you? I haven't. I thought I have. Achha. Tell me now. It's a part representing a, or it like say I just take a name of one student of this class. Teacher immediately recognizes which class I'm talking about, isn't it? Right. So I am here. You know, like it's a part referring to a whole. Right. Like this here. It is. You know, like that's a great set of wheels. Wheels of a what? A car. So I'm not just saying, oh wow, what a nice model of your car and beautiful color and all. I'm just simply saying, so what is that part representing? A car. Okay. So cynic docy is a part representing a whole. Right. Okay. So like we talk about, you know, like we talk about a heart. Right? Or the painter's hand. So it's not only the painter's hand here, we talk about the hand that created this painting. He has a good hand at art. Right? So a part here, we're talking about that whole person. Fine? Poem mein hai, has given my heart a change of. Is it? The way a crow shook down on me. The dust of snow from a hemlock tree. And say from some part of a day I had ruled. Heart is dumb. Heart, kisko represent? Kiska heart? Poet ka heart. Aur heart ke saath kya change hue? Emotions, right? So when I talk about the heart, what does it represent? Emotions. Whose heart are we talking about? The poet's heart. So the part representing the poet. Okay, so I say heart, I'm talking about the poet. I'm not talking about the crow. Okay, right? Whose feelings had changed. So the poet, earlier what was he feeling? Upset, sadness. And then, yes, so it was like he just came, stood near the which tree? And what was there about that tree, about the surrounding, which made the atmosphere even more sad? The poisonous tree. Snow on the tree, making the day very dull. Right? Okay, what am I going to do on such a day? Then the crows again. Negativity, bad omen, we talk about so many things here, right? But a little incident happened. What was that? The shaking of the snow, right? Snowflakes. Okay. And so the snow fell on the poet. And yeah, did he get angry at the bird? No. In fact, what happened as a result of it? His whole approach changed. Otherwise, it could have been because of so much negativity. He's thinking about it's a very dull, cold, boring day, right? He would have wasted that day. But because of this little incident, it lightened up his mood, it lightened up his spirit. It brought about a change of heart, changed his emotion. And then how did the day end? Did it end on a positive note or a negative note? Positive note, because then he realized that yes, it would save the rest of the day, which he would have regretted at having lost. Okay, so here, what, once again here, what could be the sequence of emotions? Negative, beginning negative towards positive, isn't it? Right? So negative in the beginning and positive toward in the end. Okay? Right? Yes, sir. Now, yeah, what fell on the poet when the crow shook a branch? Snow. Everybody knows that dust stops. So it's not, did dust fall or snow fell? Dust of snow. Attendance, how many are there? 39 to 34, 13 and 28. So five students are there. And how many online? 13. Yeah, Gursimar Jyoti is there. So dust of snow. The snow falling like dust. The snow there accumulated on the branches. Right? So after a snowfall, you see everything white, the leaves covered with snow, the branches covered with snow, and you go and shake them, it falls like little particles of. So dust did not fall, the snow fell like dust of snow. Is it a simile or is it a metaphor? Metaphor, because there is no as and like. Okay? Right. Now, yes, here. Yeah. So the poet was in a happy mood or a sad mood? Okay. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. If you have to pick out, you can look at your book if you want to. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. If I have to pick out alliteration, where is the alliteration very clearly visible? Saved some. Very nice. Very good. Right? So please. Consonants hai bhi nahi hai tumhare mein. We don't have that. I said assonants. Consonant maine bola hoga. You must have heard consonant. Consonants. We don't have consonants. Consonants bola hai, assonants bola hai. I have said this. I might have said anaphora. Okay, these are things. I might say that consonants, and you heard. We don't have any clear defined here of it. Okay, so consonants is what sound